and Raymond van Barneveld.
I don't really remember him playing bad in any of them games, to be honest. He seems to perform well.
Yeah, he did get a win against Roland Scholten, set up that tie with Phil Taylor. That's now 12 years ago. Also played 40. In many of the majors in the PDC before losing his tour card, and now he's got an opportunity here at the Lakeside, and it's one that he's looking 100. Forward to.
Yeah, he's a nice guy as well, he's Big Steve.
As for his opponent, Kevin Lute from the USA has won titles over there, including
140.
The Las Vegas Open. He's another player actually who's played on both circuits. He's also won at a CDC event
83
on the North American Tour in Philadelphia as well, and that was as recently as last year. And if he does win this match, he'll get to take on 22. Fellow American Leonard Gates in the second round. And we've said it a few times, but there really is, and it's been intentional from the WDF, there really is an international flavour to this event.
Stevie Rapaio, 164. Like this. Kevin Urukaya, 120.
120 for the first leg. He did start the leg, so it's just a hold.
41. Steve Urukaya, 68.
Steve gets a chance for the break. It's going to have to be 13 bull, I think.
43. Kevin Urukaya, 79.
Yeah, tricky finish, 79. Treble 19, the usual route, but if you hit it, it's a dodgy double. Now it's simple. Well, it is in terms of number, but he's only got half the bed to aim at. But he picks his side,
Kevin Liu,
and finds the double. Good
second
start.
Second leg, it's Steve to throw first. Game on.
There you see, he had to choose a side, didn't he?
Yeah, it was a block of that first start of the 20. Nice to get round it quite nicely, to be honest.
100.
If they get into it, I think they suit each other's throw.
Yeah, it could rattle along nicely, this one. We've seen some pretty pacey affairs in the last couple of games. Sean McDonald, a slower thrower, but the opposite of the man who beat him, Dave Parletti. That went 2-1 the way of Parletti.
41.
Veronica Rehas with a very dominant display. And we have the muffin man on stage. Well, she dished out the bagel to Paula Murphy, didn't win a leg in that match.
43.
And then Sean Burt with something of a surprise win to many against Connor Scutt, who lost in straight sets.
140.
Yeah, there's probably a lot of people who would have had Steve as the favourite for this game as well. Basically, because we don't know too much about Luke.
28.
Certainly in terms of big stage experience, there's no contest. But qualifying for the Lakeside, certainly no fluke for Luke.
102. Steve Urukaya, 124.
Don't just win a raffle to get into tournaments like this.
73.
He's got an opportunity.
Kevin Urukaya, 90.
To break here and double his lead.
Since we're where to go, the 20s. Needed the bullseye,
52.
Though.
Steve Urukaya, 51.
He's going to get a chance. Probably thought he'd blown this leg. 11 for tops. Good marker.
Game shot in the
second. Great marker.
Steve Hine.
And the leveller for Steve Hine.
Third leg against Kevin to throw first. Game on.
Luke was one of the four
85.
Alternate players that were put into the tournament. After a couple of Russian players and the Australian
38.
Number two and New Zealand number four. Jeremy Fagg and Landon Gardner pulled out. Kevin Luke came in along with Jordan Brooks and Sean McDonald, who we've seen today.
43.
And John Scott was the other one who got the late call-up. Well, all three of the other alternate players have been beaten.
140.
Kevin determined to buck that trend in this one.
Yeah, I wonder if it being a sort of a late invite affects the play of the guys.
180.
First match of the match. We're going to see the second one.
140.
Plenty of opportunity to lift those 180 cards this evening. Even saw a no-look 180, a blind 180 from Dave Parletti.
Yeah, it was a lovely interview he gave after that game.
45.
Did Dave.
Kevin, you require 153.
He wasn't showboating, but that was for his friends who came supporting him. Lovely little touch.
Steve will require 130.
Lovely little touch for Steve Hine. Treble 18.
98.
Sets it up. The pressure is placed
Kevin,
on Kevin
require
Luke.
20.
He's been up to it so far.
3rd leg.
Well put away again.
4th leg it's Steve to throw first. 61.
So a 2-1 lead for the American ace. Kevin Luke, all with throw so far.
100.
Playing at a very similar level, aren't they? And if it does carry on at that, you can expect
95.
The sets to go the distance.
Yeah, they're well matched. We'll be looking at the 5th leg decided in the last set.
85.
But a few shots like that, though, there's no real consistency at the moment. Just needs one of them to click into gear a little bit.
54.
Behind Mr. A dart at the bullseye to take the first leg.
125.
And it set up a finish when Luke went out in the third. So both players putting themselves in positions to break. But just not being given
60. Steve, you require
huge opportunities by their opponent.
95.
Well set up again there from Stevie Hine. We're back. There's Luke. Although that was a while ago.
121.
Really thought he was going to fill
Steve,
that in.
Steve, you require 40.
Pressure put on, but is it enough? Great marker. Two great markers.
Game shot in the 4th leg. Steve Hine. 5th leg, it's Kevin to throw first.
Like
game on.
From the start, it was always going to go the distance. In this first set,
42.
Now can Steve Hine find the break he needs? It was a much more convincing leg, that last one.
100.
And the pair have picked up the pace a little bit, the first couple of legs. We're in 21 darts, 17 60. And 18 since then.
75. Yeah, we always tend to give him a couple of legs just to loosen up and warm up. Usually he improves from there.
75.
A little bit of light here, if Steve can get a couple of these red bits.
135.
You open the door a little bit, Luke, and Steve stepped through.
81.
It is often the case in this set play format. Who can deliver the goods in the big legs in these set deciders?
98.
And it's Hine who's making his move. 108 when he comes back to take the set.
Steve Urukaya, 108.
Oh, he was looking for the single 16, and he opens the door for Luke.
76.
It will feel like he threw second in this leg. He actually threw first.
Urukaya, 121.
An outside chance, but it's a chance all the same. Treble 17. Hine returns.
57. Steve Urukaya, 32. Game shot and a first set.
Well, in it goes for Steve Hine, who the break, performing for the crowd, dancing back on. Might take the first couple of legs just to get the breath back.
Been there, done that.
97.
So some of the big events I've played in the past, I think the Grand Slam was one.
45.
I always wanted to be the one to do the walk-on first, for exactly that reason. Get to the table and get some air in my lungs.
What an iconic walk-on it was. The chest thumping, hey baby. From Mr. Tony O'Shea.
100.
Still opportunities for us to see it, isn't there? This life in the old silverback yet.
140.
Yeah, and the World Seniors, yeah. I really enjoyed that, the one we had at the Circus Tavern. Great old venue. A couple more coming up this year as well.
100.
I managed to blag invites for, so
80.
At least twice more this year.
One here at the Lakeside. Hine looks at tops.
Game shot in the first leg. Steve Hine.
Topping from the Muffin Man.
Second leg, it's Kevin to throw first.
That's exactly what he's done. He's backed up that break. A little leeway now.
81.
You may have heard a spluttering of applause from the crowd there. That's because Canada's Kevin Burt has just made his way to a table where some of his supporters are, and he was applauded as he walked through the arena.
100.
And rightly so. There is Mrs. Muffin. She'll have plenty to cheer about.
100. Ninety-nine.
Steve Hine down to 277.
130.
Kevin Luke staying competitive, but as Tony alluded to, he's the one now
57.
Who has to find that break.
Kevin, you require 71.
A little time to find it in this leg. Double five.
Game shot in the second leg.
Nicely finished
Kevin
off.
Kevin Liu. Third leg, it's Steve to throw first. Game on.
Parity again.
It's nip and tuck stuff.
140.
Two players on the debut, but they are two experienced throwers, and they do look like a pair whose first appearance on this iconic stage hasn't fazed them.
43.
Just getting on with it.
95.
And the game seems to be growing, getting better and better. The first set, 21 darts for the pair of them, then 17 and 18. It was a 17 dart breaker throw that won the decider for Steve Hine, but they've both kicked off with 15 darters here.
Yeah, they're warming 58. Up to the game nicely. Well settled in on the stage. The trouble is, it's only best of three sets.
It was best of nine at this rate, they'd be throwing nine darters in every leg, wouldn't they, by
58.
The end of the match?
Well, they'd have had enough practice by then. Yeah, but you do settle in, and it should be that way as well. You should slightly...
119.
Feel more comfortable on the hockey.
Steve, you require to go with 89. Throw again.
89 for Steve. Triple 19.
57.
I didn't need to take it out on the bullseye. With Luke so far behind, but he's much closer now. Breathing down the neck
Steve
of Hine.
Require 32.
Yeah, Steve played percentages. Will it pay off? Good doubt, them two.
No score. Kevin, you're
a player. I liked that he would miss, but I wasn't expecting him to miss there. He managed to get past the two darts, but not into the double. Now, can he get past that dart and into the double?
20.
He can't.
He managed that very early in the match, actually. He picked that top right corner after a blocker. Well, probably unexpected here for Steve to get another shot.
Game shot in the third leg.
He's made the most of
Steve
it.
High.
Hold his throw again.
Fourth leg, it's Kevin to throw first. Game on.
Well, we've said that these breaks win matches.
85.
One more break for Steve in this leg and he will have won the match.
93.
There's been a good flow to the game. Very similar averages at the moment as well.
Yeah, reminder, the next game coming up is the 100. Final first round match of the women's tournament. And it's the reigning world champion, Mercurio Suzuki, taking on Laura Turner in an eagerly anticipated tie. Doing a bit of news from the practice room. The bullseye contest has been done. See who will throw first in that one.
100.
Both players hit the 25 three times before Makuru bedded the bull, and Laura could only find the 25 again. So Suzuki will throw first in that match.
78.
Well, in a long match, it doesn't really matter that much, but when it's only best of three sets, that could be crucial.
I always find it interesting that often the most Kevin important dart that can be thrown is thrown in the practice room rather than on the stage.
And nobody else gets to see it.
Well, we could see. A brilliant finish here.
99.
So close. So close.
Steve, you're 126.
He's got a chance now to win the match on 126. Well, that's not going to help.
94.
So to force.
Kevin, you require 40.
Fifth leg. And a couple of sets, it's and that's what happens. Leg. And now,
Kevin
Luke has to do to Hine what
fifth
Hine did to Luke
Steve to throw first.
In set one, in. And that is breaking the decider.
60.
It's all or nothing for Luke in this leg.
60. You could see him there just taking his time, trying to compose himself before this visit.
He realises how important this leg is.
137.
Hasn't been much
between them all. We need to change that now.
But Hine just seems to be doing the damage when it counts the most.
59.
That's obviously experience for you, that. There's never a bad time to hit a 140 or one of these big scores, but timing is
125.
He's done it again.
Yep, they may play a 10-leg match here, where there were two important legs, leg 5 and leg 10, and Hine is bossing them
60.
Both.
60.
Superb dance again. Gives him 80 for the match. We're back at least, probably twice.
45. Steve, you require 80.
The stats have been very similar. Both players
48.
Averaging around the 80 mark. Both players checking out around the 35% mark. But as we were saying, it's all about the deciding 99. Leg in sets. And it's the Steve Muffin Man who's been making it count.
Yeah, good board management there. Why is it that bottom part of the board?
Game, shot,
and that good board management has won him the